Welcome to His Colors, broadcast every Saturday night on 13-way radio television. With its distinctive colors and the history charm of the former imperial capital, Hue continues to offer beautiful experiences to everyone. Let's find out what special colors on today's program. The news catching up on the most important cultural and tourism events. I love it, meeting Ms. Ho Di Sung Lan, who enhances the value of products made from Fortek Village Reed Grass. The beauty of it, admiring the nine bronze urns, recently recognized as a documentary heritage in the memory of the World Committee for Asia and the Pacific by UNESCO. In celebration of the 134th anniversary of President Ho Chi Minh's birth, the special bridge broadcasting, Lang San Bridge Great Wall, was held at two provinces, Nghệ An and Hue. Broadcast by over 40 television stations nationwide, the program deeply moved audiences with stories of the childhood and youth of the great leader.
Lang San, the starting point and root. And Hue, the witness to the early growth of the young Nguyễn Tất Thành, plays significant roles in shaping the character, culture, and profound thinking of President Ho Chi Minh. The artistic program, Lang San Raised Great Wall, brings these stories to life through music, folk tune of Nghệ An and Hue, and historical data, offering insights into the influences that shaped his revolutionary ideals. This event also represents the deep gratitude of the people from Nghệ An, Hue, and across the nation towards their beloved leader.
At 1:09 p.m. on May 8th, local time, in Ulaanbaatar, Mongolia, the documentation bus relies on the nine bronze urns in Hue Imperial Palace from Vietnam was officially approved at the Documentary Heritage of the UNESCO, Memory of the World Committee for Asia and the Pacific.
For the bas relief of the nine bronze urns in Hue Imperial Palace, congratulations!
These were the only nomination from Vietnam in this session, among 19 other documents from the region, and it received unanimous approval with 23-23 votes from the participating members. To date, nine bronze urns are the fourth documentary heritage from Hue recognized by UNESCO. Following the Nguyen Dynasty woodblocks, the royal records from the Nguyen Dynasty, and the poetry from royal architecture in Hue, the recognition of the nine bronze urns is the source of national pride of Vietnam, especially for 13 Hue province, enhancing the heritage brand of Hue, a city celebrated its 48 UNESCO World Heritage Sites.
Health tourism is becoming a popular trend among both domestic and international travelers. 13 Hue, with its natural resources, has significant potential to develop this tourism model. Currently, numerous healthcare services have been introduced by local enterprises, offering high-quality experiences to visitors.
Guests can immerse themselves in a vibrant, fresh environment and various resorts in Hue, where they can enjoy health-oriented services such as mud baths, onsen, spas, saunas, and massages, all using the naturally occurring hot springs.
The services at the resort are fantastic. They satisfy the needs of health improvement. After the stressful period at work, resting here has significantly improved my health.
Alongside health and recovery services, cuisine also plays an important role in physical improvement. Hue is known as a culinary capital, where dishes are intricately prepared not only to delight the taste, but also for their aesthetic value and health benefits.
I'm vegetarian for like 30 years, but I've never been to Vietnam before, so it was a really good opportunity to see what happens. But I've tasted so much over the last couple of weeks.
The 13 Hue tourism sector is focusing on promoting and strategically marketing Hue's health tourism to bring it closer to travelers. There is also a call for investors to research and develop high-quality healthcare tourism projects, aiming to create a distinctive brand for this type of tourism in the region.
Tofu is a simple beloved dish among his people, known for its delicious flavor. Sitting at the base of Tinmu Pagoda on a cool afternoon, enjoying a bowl of tofu while admiring the scenic beauty, offers the delightful experience. Tofu is carved into small layers, topped with a bit of smashed zinger and a little sugar water to create a classic Korean-style tofu bowl. In the past, if you wanted to enjoy this treat, you had to look for street vendors from local women known as Aw or Mei. Now, just by visiting the base of Tinmu Pagoda, whether in the morning or afternoon, you can enjoy delicious tofu served by charming women in traditional purple baba dresses. And the cost for the bowl of tofu is very affordable, 10,000 Vietnam dong. Come and enjoy this local delicacy. Grass Bank, upland attached to the daily life of the people in Phu Trạch Village, Phong Binh Commune, Phong Điền District, has been part of their culture for over 400 years. Used in making everyday household items, recognizing its value, Ms. Ho Thị Sương Lan has taken innovative steps to elevate these traditional products and introduce them to the global market. Join us in our lovely to discover more.
Khi mình nghe câu chuyện về cỏ bàng thì mình nghĩ trời ơi sao có một cái cây mà nó có thể là mạnh mẽ đến như vậy. Thì mình luôn ấp ủ là tìm kiếm những cái gì mà nó mang tính bản địa, nó đặc thù. Thì mình nghĩ ngay đến cái sản phẩm thủ công mỹ nghệ, làm sao để có thể mang được những cái sản phẩm của Việt Nam đi ra với thị trường quốc tế. Thì mình đi hết tất cả các làng nghề của Huế mà mình biết, như làng nón, làng gốm, làng thanh tiên, làng hoa giấy đó, và làng cỏ bàng. Thì khi đến đó thì cái ấn tượng của mình đối với cái cỏ bàng và cái Phu Trạch không hiểu sao mà nó thực sự rất là sâu. Thì hầu như ở miền Trung mình chỉ tìm thấy được ở Huế, cho nên cái tính đặc thù của nó rất cao, cái tính bản địa của nó rất cao. Thứ hai á, cái cỏ bàng này nó thú vị lắm. Nó có thể từ sinh từ diệt, nó mọc mà cái tinh thần của nó bất diệt, cái tinh thần sinh sôi nảy nở của nó rất chi là bền bỉ. Tại sao mình không làm? Tại sao mình không làm cỏ bàng mà mình phải tìm một cái ngành nghề khác? Cho nên mình nghĩ làm sao để biến cái cỏ bàng này nó trở thành một cái thương hiệu khác nào đó mà nó có thể đánh vào cái tệp khách hàng khác. Thì mình nghĩ ngay tới thời trang. Cho nên mình nghĩ phải làm cho cái sản phẩm này nó nhiều tiền hơn, nó đẹp hơn và người ta phải mang nhiều lần hơn bởi vì thích. Bởi vì khách hàng của mình là khách hàng cao cấp, cũng là có thu nhập và họ cũng rất là có gu về thời trang. Cho nên mình không có muốn làm cho họ thất vọng về những cái sản phẩm truyền thống của Việt Nam. Vì sản phẩm nó cũng mang cái tính tự hào rất là lớn. Sản phẩm nó vừa mang yếu tố truyền thống, nó vừa phải phù hợp với xu hướng của thị trường, nó vừa phải đáp ứng với cái thị trường khách hàng khó tính, nó vừa đảm đương được cái trách nhiệm sau này khi ổn định nó có thể xuất khẩu được và nó phù hợp với cả cái tiêu chí đánh giá của châu Âu. Và đây là mô hình mà mình không nghĩ là mình chỉ dừng lại ở cái làng nghề Phu Trạch đâu. Mình có ước mong là sau 3 năm, nếu công ty của mình đã hoàn thành cơ bản cái diện mạo cũng như là cái đầu vào đầu ra ổn định thì mình sẽ phát triển ở các cái làng nghề truyền thống khác. Và mình rất là vui vẻ để mà chia sẻ cái mô hình này đối với các làng nghề khác ở trên khắp đất nước Việt Nam.
In 2012, the Prime Minister recognized 9 bronze urns as a national treasure. Now, 12 years later, this collection of bronze masterpieces has become the fourth heritage documents of Hue recognized by UNESCO. let's appreciate the beauty and intricacy of the nine bronze urns in the Beauty of Hue.
The nine bronze urns are located in the courtyard in front of Taemyeol Temple behind Hillum Pavilion in Hue Imperial Enclosure, cast in 1835 during the reign of Imperial Manmang. These urns are connected to the sacred number 9, which in Eastern philosophy symbolizes heaven, authority, and the power of the supreme ruler. Each urn is named after a posthumous title of the Nguyen Emperors. Every urn features 18 panels with reliefs that collectively depict a panoramic view of a unified Vietnam under Nguyen Dynasty. These urns serve as a geographical chronicles expressed through the sculptural language of the 19th century Vietnam, demonstrating the pinnacle of Nguyen Dynasty bronze casting artistry. Many visitors to Hue are fascinated by the unique beauty of these architectural works. Have you ever visited Hue Imperial City to see the nine bronze urns? Don't miss out on experiencing for yourself.
Tourist heritage of Hue holds countless intriguing stories derived from the valuable assets left by our ancestors. Thus, exploring Hue is not only an exciting adventure, but also the educational journey that deepens your understanding of this historical land. Thank you for joining us on Hue Scholars. Goodbye and see you again.